what is the breadth, length, and depth, and height, and to know the love of Christ, which passeth knowledge, that ye might be filled with all the fullness of God. Now unto him that is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we could ask or think, according to the power that worketh in us. Unto him be glory in the church by Christ Jesus throughout all ages, world without end. And this is the word of the Lord.
I dare not try. testimony coming in. See, you don't understand at all. You was a little girl when I came to this church. And God has lived and let me live to get back in this church another But now, listen to me. And I was able to get back, so I was shouting a shout of victory, of joy that God. And then I watched God, how he just came on through. And look at you. When you was a little girl, they wouldn't let little girls pass us.
Down and let somebody else take it that can give something. And you
pray that God will bless you, that you will be able to give something one day. Is that all right? Give God a hand and praise.
Over here, Pastor.
But I know if you cheat God, he's going to get you. Now somebody just put something in the basket. Is that your $100? Bishop Hurley, bless the woman of God. I love her. Now, to anyone else who gets special offering, I'm looking for special offerings now. I'm looking for special offerings. Where come on in the back there? Overseer Spearman, bless you, darling. That's my daughter in the Lord. Praise the Lord. Her daddy, before he left here, passed her on to me. And she's a beautiful young lady, and I love her. Bishop Spearman, thank you, darling. Thank you. You're so precious. And I told her to meet us over here. I said, meet me over there. Oh, glory be to God. Now, oh, come on. Don't be afraid. Don't let these people intimidate you. If you want to give, you give. If you want to be blessed when you bless, and they'll be looking on the sidelines. Bless you, man of God. Bless you. Bless you. Bless you. I love it. Are there any more special blessings in the house? Now, I want you all to group up. I want you all to group up in your thoughts. In your thoughts. I want, because the way it is, I want everybody to march the house. I believe in marching the house is exercise. Okay? I need everybody to stand. Everybody to stand. Even if you've given already, I need you to stand. I need everyone to stand. I need everyone to stand. If you have nothing to give, stand. Unless you're like me, you can't move, then you're allowed to sit down momentarily. Otherwise, I want you to stand. Let us pray. Oh, gracious and everlasting Father, God, we thank you for those that have given. We thank you for those that are going to give. We ask that you bless them in a mighty way. Oh, my God, loosen up their purse strings, Lord. Let them give for your glory, your honor, and your service. We want to ask all of these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Now, give God a hand of praise. We're the ushers. And everything for ushers, I will say that. Are the ushers in the back there? Okay. If ushers in the back, I want them to start from the back. Listen, here's what I want. I want them to start from the back, come up through the middle aisle, and go down to the side aisle. You stay. Okay. And you all got it? The ushers got it? Yeah. I want you to come up the middle aisle. Up the middle aisle. And down the side aisle. Up the middle aisle. Come on, mother. You can come on. Come on with you. Come on. Because I have one of them too and I use it. Go ahead and the Lord use it. Give the best offering. I need no less than $20. No less than $25. If you write a kind of check, make it out to kingdom life. If you write a check, make it out to kingdom life. If you write a check for $1, make it out to kingdom life. If you're writing out a check, make it out to Kingdom Life, okay? If you heard the app sign for giving, if you're giving, praise the Lord. God bless you as you march. Come on, march. Bless the saints. Bless the saints. Thank you. Thank you for blessing. Thank you. bless you. We're not taking it for granted. God will bless each and every one of you. Just hold on to his hand. Now give God a hand of praise. As our ministry son-in-law, our pastor, that will come forth and continue this program. God bless you, Lord.
Thank you. everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody.
Oh, God, we bless.
Jesus. Thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Is he not a wonderful God? Is he not just the best thing you've ever seen? The best thing you've ever felt? Amen. Because even though God is a spirit, and we worship him in spirit and in truth, amen, you can still see him. I might be messing with somebody's theology right now, but I believe you can still see him. I believe you can see him in a changed life.
Yeah.
I believe you can see him in a changed season. I believe you can see him every time, amen, when you don't know where your next meal is coming from, or maybe you've never been there before. I believe you can see him, glory to God, when you don't know. All right, put it this way. My mama used to say, there have been times in my life when I had to say, I don't know how it's going to happen, but before you know it, somehow, somewhere, it happened. I believe you can see it when the doctor said, I don't have a clue. And somehow, in some way, the next morning when they come in your room and they say, I don't know what happened. For his goodness and his mercy. You didn't have your seats. Thank you for your remembrance. But see, I can get lost right there. Y'all ain't saying nothing.
Thank you, Lord.
So I thank God today for his goodness and his mercy. Amen. Certainly I honor the Lord today, Pastor Penford. God bless you. Thank you.
with me. I certainly will not be for you very long on tonight. Amen. Because we're supposed to be at the airport at 7 o'clock. Right. Amen. So we're going to have to do it. Don't y'all say that. There is a little boy in my house who's trying to be looking right now, standing. I tell you what, you better make sure you're on that plane. Amen. The plane leaves at 9, so y'all pray. Thank you, Jesus. We're going to get there. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Y'all pray. All right, y'all pray. Amen. Certainly, amen. We are grateful, amen, for this entire weekend. I learned that the Lord is an amazing God. God bless you, Bishop Butler. Amen. Certainly to all of our ecclesia on today, amen. To overseer, God bless you. Amen. Certainly to all the presbytery. I do not mean to leave anyone out, to everyone in the kingdom assignment. Amen. To those that I know and do not know, God bless you. To all the dignitaries, the theologians, to every one of my Father's children, God bless you. To our musicians, our Levites, God bless you. Amen. We thank God for you on today. Amen. I'm caught between two thoughts, so I'm going to try to put them together, if that's all right. Amen. Let's go to the book of Numbers. Archbishop said, well, you know you're a doctor of theology now. Amen. Archbishop, don't make me go to the band and get my degree and shout all over this church. Lord, have mercy. Amen. It was a long time coming. But it's here now. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Listen, let's go to the book of Numbers, the 27th chapter. The book of Numbers, the 27th chapter. And we're going to begin with verse 1. And whatever the custom is of this house, as it relates to the reading of God's word, we would that you would do that now. Yesterday I had to try to be an academician. And so today I'm going to try to be what I do. Amen. It is my passion. Preaching is my passion. Amen. Preaching is what brings me through. When I am sad, I want to preach. When I'm happy, I want to preach. When I'm mad, I have to preach. So I won't cut nobody. Y'all ain't saying nothing. Amen. I'm an only child. I was raised on the south side of Chicago. So when I'm mad, amen, folk would want me to preach. Amen. So I thank God. It is my passion. It is my assignment in the earth. Amen. They gave me a magazine article on me one day, and the guy who did it, he titled it, I'm Returning the Favor. And I'm asking why did he entitle the interview that. He said, because you made one statement that caught me. He said, he asked me why did I go so hard for ministry and for kids in the community. And I told him, I said, because I did every ministry for the devil. And so I tried my best to return the favor. He tried to kill me, and now I try to kill him. I tried to go along and say nothing. I tried to return the favor. Amen. Every young soul I see, I can see kids involved. I'm like, look, do something different with your life. Don't be nothing, be something. Amen. Because you were born to be more than that. Amen. We were in the story. Numbers chapter 27, verse 1, Iris, countdown, 32 minutes, ready, let's go. Then came the daughters of Zelophehad, the son of Hephea, the son of Gilead, the son of Mishir, the son of Manasseh, of the families of Manasseh, the son of Joseph. And these are the names of his daughters, Mahla, Noah, and Hogla, and Milcah, and Tirzah. And they stood before Moses and before Eleazar the priest, and before the princess and all the congregation by the door of the tabernacle of the congregation, saying, our fathers died in the wilderness, and he was not in the company of them that gathered themselves together against the Lord in the company of Korah, but died in his own sin and had no sons. Why should the name of our father be done away from among his family because he had no son? Give unto us therefore a possession among the brethren of our father. And Moses brought the cause before the Lord. And the Lord spake unto Moses, saying, the daughters of Zelophehad speak right. Thou shalt surely give them a possession of an inheritance among their father's brethren. And thou shalt call the inheritance of their father to pass unto them. And thou shalt speak unto the children of Israel, saying, if a man die and have no son, then he shall cause his inheritance to pass unto his daughter. Then he shall give his inheritance unto his daughter, shall pass unto his daughter. Verse 9, and if he have no daughter, then it shall give his inheritance unto his brother. I'm going to stop right there for the sake of time. I want to talk to you, amen, from the subject, the simple subject, my daddy said yes. And the three words I want to take, amen, my daddy said yes. My next three words shall simply be this. How shall we be not? Okay, that's four words. How shall we not? How shall we not? Tell somebody around you, ask somebody, how shall we not? How shall we not? We, amen, some of us may know the history of this, and some of us may not, amen. We may not understand that the daughters of Zelophehad, these were, this was found in Numbers, found in how the nation of Israel, it was being numbered, how when they came out of Egypt and they came out of the wilderness, and now they are over in the promised land, and they are being numbered. They are going through the census, and they are divvying off, for a better lack of a better term, the land and where they're going to set up and how they are gaining inheritance and gaining possessions. And you have to understand in this time how they they had an inheritance, it was simply because of the men had to get the inheritance. You understand? And when the men got the inheritance, it was the responsibility. Let me talk to our men for just a few minutes. It was the responsibility of the men to take care of the family. I feel, amen, my dissertation coming back around. Will it go round in circles? It was the responsibility of the man to take care of the family. If my house needed to be built, the man built it. I watch HGTV, Bishop Butler, and I just can't understand. I'm a girly girl. Girly preacher. I'm a girly girl for real. I don't want to build a house. I don't want to take a sledgehammer and y'all understand about that. I'm the person that goes to Walmart and I walk through the door gate because the door don't open. Y'all ain't saying nothing. Like that. I'm the person that will stand at the steps and wait for a gentleman to come because I believe there are just certain
and raised where I'd already been born. I was raised in the era where, you know, the women, y'all know what we did, they did. Back around 73-ish, they would be singing the song, I can bring home the bacon, fry it up in the pan. Y'all remember that? Every woman, it's all in me. Y'all remember that? And the man said, all right, we'll go ahead and do you. Do what you do. And they sat down. They stopped working, y'all. They said, do what you do. But you got to understand, child of God, there was a time when it didn't matter whether it was the father of the house, whether it was the brother of the house. Very first lawsuit of the Bible. We find the daughters of Zelophehad in the orders for the division of the land just given. There was no provision had for females in case of failure of male issue. In other words, if there was no male present, there was no law ever written for females to come up and get the inheritance. So you find here, the five daughters of Zelophehad, therefore, considered themselves as destitute, having neither father nor brother, and being themselves entirely overlooked. And they agreed to refer the cause to Moses and the rulers, whether it were not equitable that they should inherit their father's portion. Why should we not inherit our father's portion? Because we have no brother. It is not our fault that my daddy had five girls. It is not our fault that there is no man to stand and plead our cause. But we got a mouth. We got something inside of us that tells us it's still mine. I still deserve it. Glory to God. I may not have crossed every T. I may not have dotted every I. I may not have done the things that I should have done when I should have done it. But God says you still have an inheritance. God says you still have the things that I promised you that you would have. You still have the things, amen, set in place. But you got to open your mouth and say something. You got to open your mouth, amen, and declare the works of the Lord. You got to open your mouth, amen, and begin to speak what God says. Speak how he says. The oracles of God must come forth out of your mouth. The Bible says here, amen, they go to Moses. Hallelujah. This leads to the enactment of an additional law to the civil code of Israel. This leads to, oh God, I love you, an enactment of an additional law. This law hadn't been written yet, Pastor Pettibord. Nobody wrote this law. Nobody thought about this law. So there has to be an additional law written. There has to be an enactment. These five girls. Somebody say girl power. This, amen, enactment has to now come forth. Moses says, I don't know about that. He says, let me take this to the Lord. There is a thing, glory to God, that has to go before God. When you pray, the Bible says, come on, let's ride. The Bible says that when you pray, you must believe what you pray about. In you, your word, his word abide in you. In my word abide in you. He said you can ask what you will, and it shall be done unto you. Glory to God. Moses said, let me go to God. Let me find out what it is I must do now. There is a thing that'll make the bishop scratch his head. There is a thing that'll make the apostle say, let me go on my knees and pray. We find now, glory to God, here is the first lawsuit ever come forth in the Bible by five girls. Glory to God. And in this lawsuit, the Lord doesn't know what to do. I hear the old
again. Go back and sing again. Go back and sing again. Go back and sing again. Go back and look again.
Yes, it is, girl.
his only son, how shall he not freely give us all things? Your daddy said yes. Others said no, but daddy said yes. That's why you got a doctorate. That's why you're getting ready to put on purple.
He's yielded his life to you, Archbishop. He's yielded his life to you. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father.
Yes,
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. This is covenant. This is covenant. The Itamasha, this is covenant. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Somebody say, my daddy says yes. How shall he not? How shall he not? Freely with him. Give us all things. Thank you, Jesus.
This is your moment. I said, this is your moment. the person next to you and say, neighbor, I know we live in a season where we want to get out of church. Tell somebody, I'm not leaving until I get something out of church. Y'all ain't said it to the right person. Look at somebody else and tell them, I know we live in a season where we want to get out of church, but I'm not leaving until I get something out of church. I came here for healing. I came here for deliverance. I came here for breakthrough. Look at somebody and tell them, if it ain't but one miracle in here, I'm going to be the one to get it. I don't hear nobody in here. Look at somebody and tell them, if it ain't but one deliverance in here, I'm going to be the one to get it. I've been through too much.
It's not.
not their title that we should hear. It's their touch that we should hear. Somebody will tell them, I need to hear what you wear. Back it up in scripture, and I will give you the garment of praise in exchange for the spirit of heaviness. Anybody in here been through some heavy seasons? Look over somebody and tell them, change your clothes right now. And take your heaviness off and put on the garment of praise. Y'all ain't saying nothing to me. I'm nervous when I come to church in the middle of a pandemic and you ain't praising him. I said, put on a praise right now. Don't you know God kept you coming? It wasn't nothing that you did. It was the sound of your garment.
So I'm honored as well. I said, we're going to take this home. We're going to Patterson, to your home church, because
accept Gail Latrice in the office of overseer and give your cooperation, support, and prayers, Lord, as she seeks to carry out the responsibilities of this office. And the congregation says,
we will do so.
In order that we may know your mind and purpose, that you may be strengthened in your resolve. To fulfill your ministry, you must answer to the questions we now put to you. Are you ready, with all faithful diligence, to seek and promote the truth of Christ, and to defend the church against all doctrine contrary to God's word? Will you be sober, righteous, and devout in this present world, that you may show yourself in all things an example of God, of good work unto others, and to the honor and glory of God?
I will, by the help of God.
Will you show yourself gentle and merciful for Christ's sake, to poor and needy people, and to all strangers destitute of help?
By the help of God.
Will you devote yourself to prayer, to reading the Holy Scriptures, to such studies as may deepen your faith and increase your love, reverence, and service to God?
I will, for the love of God.
Will you accept the discipline of the church and faithfully exercise authority within it?
I will, by the help of God.
Will you be faithful in ordaining and appointing others, and will you ever seek to deal just and kindly with those who are in the ministry over whom you are placed as overseer?
I will, by the help of God.
My sister Gail Patrice, as an overseer, you are called upon with all faithful diligence to seek the truth of Christ and defend the church against all doctrine contrary to the word of God. As an overseer, you are to serve and assist the presiding prelate and bishops in managing the Kingdom Life Fellowship International, assist pastors in the growth and greater development of their churches, and preside over the temporal and disciplinary affairs as they are assigned to you. You are to assist bishops in the ordination of elders and in the celebrations of communion. You are to promote the agenda and expansion of the Kingdom Life Fellowship International for the greater good of the kingdom. You are to render due diligence in the observation and careful concern of your fellow episcopates so as to qualify for the next order of episcopal elevation. as you enter the lower house of the Episcopal to see my sister Gail. You've carried much things in life. You felt the weight of many things in ministry. But this level requires that you feel the weight of the church. Jesus' church. You must share in the burden. You must share in the cross. You heard when he said, if anyone come after me, let him deny himself, take up his cross, and follow me. Must Jesus bear the cross alone and all the world go free? No, there's a cross for everyone. There's a cross for me. Archbishop, would you place the weight of the church? The weight of Noah. Feel the weight. Feel the weight. You're an Episcopate now. This is another level of burden. This is another level of care. You sit at the table of government for the Church of God. There's a greater responsibility that comes with it now. This is not about a title. This is about a touch. Feel the weight. This cassock is the robe of a servant. bishop will say the titles for our bishop. After the garment that Jesus wore, this is the garment that they gambled over as he hung off the cross. You place a cassock over the overseer who will be covered in humility as she wears this robe. The overseer will serve God and the people of God forever, as long as her life remains. We ask that she wears this robe as one who honors the Lord as a servant. The cincture, in French, it is the belt. It goes around the waist for the girding up of the episcopate. There are two strings of fabric that hang from this belt. These strings represent that towel that Jesus wore when Jesus washed the feet of his disciples. As great as Jesus was, in case you didn't know it, he was God wrapped in flesh. He still was high enough to be God, but humble enough to serve. Elevation is your portion when you know that the best way up is to go down. So we place this cincture. Worn over the rochet. It is the symbol of the prophet church becomes the chief defender of the church. Let me say this. She is an overseer. The overseer is the lower house of the Episcopal See, which means that she is in the line of the bishop when it's not a mandate or promise that she will be. But she is now qualified to be tutored in the area of the bishopric. And as an episcopate, she is considered chief defender of the faith, preacher of the doctrines of the church. This is the symbol that set her apart as one who speaks the things which become sound doctrine. Church. You're married to the church. You preach a doctrine of reconciliation, love, compassion. You don't beat people with this word. You feed people with this word. You treat the people of God as a spouse to be prepared for her bride, for her husband. The word of God is presented to you. It is infallible. It is the only thing you preach. You don't preach the New Jersey Times. You don't preach 10 o'clock news. Every answer that this church needs is within these 66 books. Search these scriptures. Study to show thyself unto me. You're a doctor now. You're a theologian. You are required to use the scriptures to support anything you say God said. If it's not in there, it's not God.
Thank you.
voice now. Because if there's no documentation, this event never took place. Thank you.
God for all that he has done this entire weekend. And I want to say thank you, Archbishop, for being such a blessing to me. I appreciate you. I love you. I thank God for the times that we sat down and talked. We ate. I thank God for being in your home and you shared with me. You remind me, as I told you, you remind me of my former pastor, Bishop R.A. Jones. And then you remind me of Bishop Pettiford, where I sat in his office and we laughed and we talked. And I'm just grateful that he replaced that emptiness with another father figure. I thank God for you, and I appreciate you so much for this weekend. Because of Archbishop, I received my doctorate degree in ministry. And I was a little nervous yesterday because I didn't give the proper accolades like I should have, because I was trying to stay within my time frame. We had 5 minutes to expound on defend our dissertation. And I was nervous and I was trying to stay within my time, and I didn't give honor and recognition to whom I should have done first. But thank you so very much. I appreciate you and love you.
Bless you, God.
Amen. And I want to say, God bless you, Bishop Fabian. Could you please stand, Bishop Tucker? Fabian Q. Tucker.
Q.
I thank God for you so much. You've been a man of God in my life, and I appreciate you for what you've done. Again, you also have made all this possible. I thank you for being a part of this fellowship. I thank you for what we go through, and I thank God that we are here for each other. I thank God that I have walked with you, and it's been a blessing and a privilege, and I thank God for you. It is awesome. Thank you again for just being such a blessing to me, introducing me to Archbishop, and now look what I have. And so my daddy said yes, hallelujah. So I want to present you guys something, and I also want, before we even move forward, I don't know, today is Deacon Coley Wu's birthday. And I just want to say thank you, Pastor Pam. I want to say thank you so much for allowing us to be here. I appreciate you all, my sister. But she is my sister. Her mother used to dress us like twins when we were growing up. I ain't gonna never forget that. I thank God for her, and I thank God for this ministry. This is my home. I grew up here, and I wanted Dr. Moody to be a part of this. Pastor Linda, Elder Kelvin, Pastor Gloria, I'm sorry, Pastor Kelvin and Pastor Gloria, my sister in love, Elder Deborah Boyd Burton. Oh my God. Deborah, I was too sure. Deborah Richardson, amen. Right, exactly. Thank you, Elder Kitchens, for he's the one who put the program. First of all, he's the one who put the press print. And add a little more color to it. I thank God for him. I thank God for my sister Laverne. Please stand up. My natural sister, I thank God for her so much. Bishop Butler, thank you so much. Everyone, Elder Carissa, thank you so much. Overseer Crystal, thank you so much. I was at your service and I was delighted to be there. Everyone, musicians, everyone, I just want to go on. But I want to present this right now to Archbishop. I want to say thank you so much.
Bless you, God.
Thank you. It is a little present of our love. Bishop Fabian Tucker, thank you so much. Please do not open up together because you might have the same thing. Did you hear that? Do not open it up at the same time because you might have the same thing. Deacon Coley, if you could come down here, please, and let me just say thank you to you personally for sharing your time with me on your birthday. I did want not forget you. Pastor Kim, I did not get a chance to go finish going to the store. But I have to go. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. Wait a minute. They said I couldn't sing that. So I
So now I got to do it the way, the other way. Happy birthday to you.
would say I'm doing one of these great writers in this ministry for what God wants to do in this ministry. No other church in this area has it. There's even a GED program, high school equivalency program, that you have been talking about to keep people in the ministry. And those things that have been lacking in the ministry over the last 17 to 18 months, God said, I'm going to return unto you the years that the caterpillar and the cankerworm and the popworm has tried to devour, and there's wheat on the floor. So where there was a place where there may have been no soil, God still will cause harvest to come out the floor. He has favored your life, woman of God, and the mantle of the predecessor rests on the successor. Everything that was done while the predecessor lived, the Lord said, you're preparing this season to do even greater. And whoever left, we got three words for them. We remain alive. Everybody standing. Just take your right hand and wave it over the person next to your head and tell them favor.
Yeah.